Hello? Hello. Today, I'm back to share with you some stuff I like. In the early years of my YouTube channel, I used to post favorites videos, and I haven't posted one of those in a minute. Reason being, plain and simple, is I am a creature of habit. I say this all the time, but if I love a product, I will likely always be using it. So it got kind of difficult for me to keep up with favorites videos every single month. I didn't have enough shit to compile together to do favorites videos, so I kind of stopped doing them, but I like a lot of stuff. Not only makeup, lifestyle stuff, household stuff, food, clothing. I have just a plethora of items that I like. So rather than calling this a favorites video, I think I'm just gonna name this Stuff I Like. Unless we can come up with a better name in the comments below, I would love if we could brainstorm a new name for the series. I don't wanna call it a favorites series because, I don't know, the word favorite just feels like too much of a commitment for me, okay? So let's see if we can come up with another name. Otherwise, I'm just gonna call this Stuff I Like. All right, now that we got that out of the way, let's get into it. It feels natural to work my way through the makeup first, so I'm gonna start out with some of the makeup items that I have been loving, starting with the Annabelle Perfect Blushes. I have mentioned these in a previous video. I think it was my What's in My Travel Makeup Bag. These must have been repackaged recently because I remember Annabelle carrying blushes from my retail days, but I had never purchased any of my own. Now that Annabelle has repackaged these and put them in this beautiful little clear componentry, I just felt more drawn to them. I am so glad that I picked these up. I think they're $5 a pop, maybe $6 from Walmart. They are so pigmented, they're so smooth. The shades that I have here are Rosebud, which is a really pretty cool toned pink. I have Spring Petal, which is a really beautiful bright peachy shade. This is very comparable to one of my peachy MAC blushes. I think I mentioned that in my travel bag video as well. These remind me a lot of my MAC blushes. And the last one that I have is Lotus, and this is a really pretty pale, cool-toned, mauve-y pink. This is perfect for my skin when I'm really, really fair and not self-tanned. Even when I am self-tanned, it looks really pretty. It reminds me a lot of the balm. I can't think of the name of it off the top of my head, but I'll put an image of it up here somewhere with the name. Reminds me a lot of that, but a fraction of the price. These are incredibly pigmented. There's a bunch of other shades that I want to pick up, but these are the ones that I have been loving for months and months now. They're an incredible value, and I believe Annabelle is cruelty-free as well. Unfortunately, I don't think that they sell Annabelle outside of Canada, but I know that you're able to buy Annabelle products on their website, so highly, highly recommend these. I'm a sucker for a good blush, what can I say? I've got two more to share with you. These are the Burt's Bees Natural Blushes with Bamboo, Honey, and Vitamin E. I've got the shade Toasted Cinnamon, which is very unique to my collection. This is unlike any blush shade that I own. It kind of looks like a bronzer, but it's not. It's kind of like a deep peachy brown with a yellow undertone. It is so freaking pretty on the skin. These just apply like a dream. I love the honeycomb componentry on the actual blush itself. It does have little honeycombs. So when I apply these blushes, I dip my brush to the perimeter of the pan so that I can preserve that really cute honeycomb print on the center. Then I've got Bare Peach, which is absolutely stunning. This is a warm peachy shade. I have both of these on my face right now. So what I did is I took Toasted Cinnamon and I applied it to the majority of my cheek, and then I took Bare Peach and I applied it to the apples of my cheeks, and I think together they look absolutely gorgeous. These just, like I said, blend like a dream. They're very pigmented. A little bit goes a long way. There's also a pinky shade called Shy Pink that I've been meaning to pick up. Haven't gotten around to it, but I really want it because it looks gorgeous as well. I think there's only three shades right now. I picked these up from Target in the US for just over $9. And I think in Canada, you can get these at Shoppers Drug Mart. If not, you can check out the walmart.ca website. I think they go for about $14 or $15. Aside from their tinted chapsticks and lip balms and stuff like that, The blushes are the only items from their makeup range that I've tried. I've kind of been eyeing their pressed powders, so if you guys have tried those, let me know what you think of them in the comments below. Next up, I've got a tinted lip oil by e.l.f. I also mentioned this in my What's in My Travel Makeup Bag video. This is a discontinued shade. It's e.l.f. by Siriano, and it's in the shade Polished Pink. This is such a fabulous shade. It's a pale pink, and it reminds me a lot of a Smashbox lip gloss that I used to rock in my early 20s. It's the only lip gloss that I repurchased more than 10 times back in the day. This reminds me so much of it, and it has completely replaced my Buxom Full-On Lip Cream in Lavender Cosmo, which goes for about 23 or 24 Canadian dollars. This was $6 US, so I'd say that's a steal. I got a backup of it from Target.com, thank God. Although this is discontinued and you can't get this shade, I really like the formula. It's pigmented, but it's sheer. But it's pigmented. It doesn't really make a lot of sense. It's very hydrating too. It's not sticky like a lip gloss. It's more of, it isn't oily. I don't know why they call it an oil. It doesn't feel oily. It doesn't bleed the way that an oil would. I like to build this up. So what I do is I'll apply it to my lips. I'll leave it on for a couple minutes. My lips will absorb the hydrating component of the formula, and then I'll apply another layer, and then it's a little bit more opaque. I think they have about 8 different shades on the e.l.f. website, at least the last time I checked. It's so comfortable. I would highly recommend these. I wish they would bring this shade back. It's so pretty. Yeah, I've really been loving it. I've got a Marc Jacobs mascara that I've really been loving that I'm almost out of. It makes me kind of sad. This is the Velvet Noir Major Volume Mascara in the shade Noir. I'm absolutely obsessed with the wand on this bad boy. It volumizes the lashes. It makes them appear thicker. It's just beautiful. It adds like the type of clump that you would want. It doesn't clump your lashes to look like spider lashes. It clumps them in a way that looks like you have so many lashes that they don't know what to do with themselves, and they just, you know? I don't think I'm making a lot of sense, but this mascara is amazing. I'm definitely gonna repurchase it. Oh, and sidebar, I was on the e.l.f. website and I noticed that they have a new mascara now that has a wand that looks very similar to this one. The last time I checked, they were all sold out, so I signed up for the email notification when it's back in stock. I will keep you posted on that. The formula is amazing too. It doesn't make your lashes feel crunchy. It doesn't flake. Whenever I get a comment on my Instagram asking me what is on my bottom lash line, it's usually this. So I would highly recommend it. And this is a note to self, order yourself another tube when you're editing this. Please and thank you. I've been reminiscing about my childhood a lot lately for some reason. And I remember every single time one of my parents would leave the house to go to the grocery store, and I was aware of it, I would tag along. And every single time we went to the grocery store, I would leave with some form of Lip Smackers item. I have been searching the ends of the earth for Lip Smackers lip sparklers. I will put images of everything I'm talking about up on the screen, and the second you see these, you will know exactly what I'm talking about, and you will be teleported back to the sixth grade, smothering your lips in this stuff, feeling really grown before a school dance. I have not been able to find these anywhere. I saw them on Amazon for a really ridiculous price. I don't even know if they're legit. So I was in Target one night, as I usually am, and I was perusing around the aisles. I didn't have Chris behind me with a stopwatch breathing down my neck. He was in the men's section living his best life, and I don't want to get your hopes up. I did not find the lip sparklers, but what I did find are the liquid lip smackers. We've got tropical punch, watermelon, cotton candy, sponge sugar, and strawberry. Do I wish they were the sparklers? Yes. Will I be happy with these? Yes, this is the greatest $8 I've spent in a very long time. And yes, the second that these met my lips, I was brought back to my childhood. The smell alone just, I swear, it like teleports you back to being a kid. And I have been smothering my lips with these before applying my lip color every single day. I usually like to keep a different one in my purse depending on the mood I'm in. These have made me just so happy. Yeah. Stuff I like. This is the stuff I like. I'm 31 years old, by the way. Apparently all the stuff I like makeup wise was mentioned in my What's in My Travel Makeup Bag video, but I can't help it. I just thought I would reiterate that I like this stuff. These are eyelashes that I found on Amazon. I have repurchased these several times. They're by the brand Purelor. They come in a set of 3. I think they're going for that mink lash look, but they're faux mink, they're synthetic hairs, which I appreciate. I don't feel right about mink lashes. These look really pretty. The band on these is actually a lot thinner and slimmer than mink lashes, in my opinion. I like to wear these after I've trimmed them. I find that they look really flattering on the outer corners of my eyes, and I had them on in a few of my more recent videos, just on the outer edge of my eyes, and I think they look so pretty. They're really inexpensive, and I have just been loving Amazon lashes. I've been buying lashes on Amazon for a while now. I think I might compile some of my favorite things and do some videos on that if you guys would be into it. By the way, I didn't even mention, on my eyes today, I've got on the e.l.f. Opposites Attract palette. I've been testing this out for a little while. I've got on this shade here as well as this one. I'm not going to include this as part of my stuff I like. I do like it, but I want to go more in depth in a dedicated e.l.f. haul that I've got coming up. This little face and body sculpting eco tools brush has been absolutely fabulous for applying self-tanner to my feet, my hands, and my neck. All of the areas that can look really gross and patchy or uneven, this helps with, especially the hands and the feet. Nothing is worse than self-tanner hands. After I'm done self-tanning my body with the gloves, I like to pump just a drop of self-tanner on here, and then I run it along the tops of my hands, the sides of the hands, which is like a really huge problem area, just right underneath here where the wrist is, on my feet, down my neck. Like, this area right here is a problem area for me because my neck has creases through it, so a lot of product gets stuck in here. Let's say I apply this before bed, which I normally do, and then I sit there scrolling through Instagram, my neck will start creasing, and then those creases will appear very prominent the next day, even after I've washed off the color guard. So this little guy comes in really handy. I don't think they have this exact one anymore. I checked the Eco Tools website. They look like they've replaced it with something called the Bronze Buki, which is similar to this. It's a smidge smaller, but I think it'll get the job done. The main thing is the bristles are really short and they're really soft, and Eco Tools brushes across the board are usually super super soft, and that softness is what helps the self tanner blend really seamlessly. So if you're a self tanner like me, I would highly recommend this little guy or the Bronze Buki, whatever it's called now, because it does a really fabulous job. On to some non-beauty related stuff I like, which I kind of like more than the beauty stuff, to be completely honest. This next item has changed my life and my eyeballs. You guys are like me, you're likely spending most of your life in front of a computer, an iPad, a phone, just bombarded by blue light. It affects me in all sorts of ways. I get headaches, I get migraines, sore eyeballs, and I can't do anything about it because that's part of my job. Chris bought me these Felix gray eyeglasses. They're not vision glasses, they're blue light canceling glasses. So the lenses on these are kind of a yellow hue, and they help to cancel out blue light. So I wear these when I'm on the computer working, and I try to wear them when I'm on my phone before bed because blue light keeps you up at night. Everything keeps me up at night. These are really good for anybody that is bombarded by blue light from work or school. They help with blurred vision or dry eyes, or you know the headaches that you get behind your eyeballs? I normally get those from staring at my screen for too long. They help with all of that stuff. So I especially like to wear them when I'm editing because I'll be editing until all hours of the night and I won't even notice that I'm leaning into my computer and that I probably shouldn't even be in front of a computer that late at night because then I'm not gonna get any sleep. The style that I have is Jemison, and it's in a Tortoise whiskey shade. I also really want the black ones. I think they'd be super cute, but this big nerdy frame is called Jemison. I love them a lot. They make a really huge difference when I'm sitting in front of the computer. Sometimes Chris catches me without them on and he'll yell at me from across the house and bring them to me, but I'm trying my best because my vision right now apparently is 20/20, and I really don't want to fuck that up because everybody in my family has glasses. Blue eyes, I'm pretty sure, are more sensitive and more prone to vision loss or something like that. I think I read that somewhere, and I've made it to 31 with no glasses, so I'd like to maintain that streak. Anyway, I highly recommend these. Maybe put them on your Christmas list. I know I'm gonna be putting the black ones on my list this year. I've got some adorable bralettes from Target that I want to share with you. I love the style. I have purchased them in multiple colors. These are just perfect. And listen, I got some tiggle bitties on me, okay? My boobs are pretty large, and these give me the perfect amount of support that I need to live my life while also looking chic. I love to wear these bralettes when I've got kind of like an off-the-shoulder sweater. They're super cute. They've got a cross back. I've got one in olive. I also have like a deep red one. I'm currently wearing a black one, and I have a backup black one in the wash right now. I like to wash these in a little laundry bag because they can get snagged pretty easily. They don't have any padding, but there is a little bit of a thicker fabric kind of like where your nipples are, so if your nipples do get hard, you don't see them through your bra. This lace detail underneath the cup looks super pretty on the top of your stomach area. I love these so much. I get them in a medium. They're all that I've been wearing lately. I don't remember the last time I wore a regular bra. And like I said, I got some jugs, and they give me support and they make me feel really cute. Sometimes bras suffocate me. These breathe. You know, I'll probably end up getting every single color. And while I'm at it, I'm also gonna list one of my favorite sports bras from Target, if they still have it, in the description box. I'll also link these because I'm gonna use that link because I actually wanna buy some backups just in case. I'm just loving bralettes lately. Another fashion item I'd like to share with you from Target are these beautiful faux leather, faux fur, backless mules. These are like backless loafers, and they are almost identical to some Gucci ones that I saw online for $995 fucking dollars. These were $24.99, and they look identical to them. These are by the Target brand A New Day. They're faux leather, they're faux fur, and they're $24.99. I imagine that the Gucci ones are real fur and real leather, so that's gonna be a no for me, dog. Yeah, these are just so chic. They're cute. They're perfect for those days where I have to run to the bank and I have to do some adult shit and I look and feel like a bag of dicks, but I kind of want to look pulled together, so I'll throw on a pair of jeans and throw these little loafers on and head on my way. They make me look and feel like I'm trying, you know, more so than when I throw on a pair of Nike slides and go to the bank. I also want to get the ones that don't have fur and that have a back, and then I also want to get the ones that don't have a back that don't have the fur. They're just so comfortable, and they're cute, and they look high-end, but they're not. So if you're into this look, I would highly recommend these. I've got a crossbody bag that I picked up from Target for $17.99 that I've really been loving. It's in the shade dark gray. I wouldn't say it's a gray, I'd say it's more of a taupe. It's really nice. It's got a thin adjustable strap. It's like that pebble faux leather. It is perfect for travel. So I bought this specifically for my Disney trip because although I love having a big bulky bag that I can fit my entire existence into, that's not really practical for going on rides and walking around a lot, especially in super busy packed areas. There's nothing more annoying than somebody running into you with a giant purse. So I bought this and it worked out perfectly. It's got a zipper top. It has quite a few compartments in here for me to store my cell phone, our passports, some pens, makeup, whatever I need. And then it's got a front pocket. I really love the gold detail, and I just love how thin it is. When it's up against your body, it's not too bulky. I don't like cross body bags that stick out too far when I'm wearing them. It's perfect for travel. I'm gonna bring it to Vegas with me. I just love Target's handbag section. If I could, I'd buy every single one. I think they're so chic and affordable. This comes in black, and I really want that one as well. They didn't have it in store when I picked this one up. And they also have a really pretty, kind of like a mustard colored one. Anyway, pretty great for $17.99. My battery died, and I got bored. Cheers! When I sat down to compile all of the stuff I like for this video, I just knew I had to share these items with you. I got a couple mugs from Target for $1.99, and they are the cutest little things I have ever seen. I want to get two more, but honestly, I'm running out of room because I'm a mug addict. If there was a mug collector anonymous, I would be a part of it. How freaking cute are these? I just love this color. They look small, but they're not. They hold a lot of liquid. They also come in white and gray. I also got a couple of cereal bowls in this style. Can we just take a moment to appreciate how freaking cute these are? I mean, $1.99 each. Are you kidding me? 10 out of 10 would recommend. Since I just shared that adorable little mug with you, I may as well tell you what I love to fill it with lately. Now, this in front of me is just half of the dynamic duo that I'm about to tell you about. This is the Trader Joe's Blueberry Lavender Flavored Almond Milk. This stuff is absolutely amazing, delicious, and it's only seasonal. So the last time I went to Trader Joe's, you bet your tits I bought like 8 of them, okay? What I love doing is taking the Trader Joe's Earl Grey tea, making myself a little tea, and then taking this almond milk, frothing it in my frother until it's nice and voluptuous, and then pouring it over my Earl Grey tea, adding a little bit of honey, and making myself a blueberry lavender London fog. Oh my God. It is the most delicious London fog I have ever had. When you're done watching this video, leave your house, go to your nearest Trader Joe's, and buy whatever's left on the shelf of this. Please, do it for me, because it would pain me to know that somewhere at some Trader Joe's, there are cartons of this sitting on the shelf unpurchased, okay? Don't go to the one in Washington though, because that's the one that I go to and I want to clear that place out. Don't go to that one, especially if you love London fogs. This is just so nice. It has the right amount of blueberry and lavender flavor so it doesn't overpower your tea, but you definitely taste it as you're drinking your London fog. So freaking good. Love it. Can't get enough of it. Okay, last but not least, I've got a little food item from Trader Joe's. This was very last minute because I was so excited to see that it was back in stock. These are seasonal. These are their peppermint pretzel slims. These are basically yogurt covered pretzels with crushed candy cane on top, and they are absolutely delicious. I feel like I should do a video dedicated to my favorite Trader Joe's foods, because you guys seem to really like the skincare one. And I go to Trader Joe's once a week and I know what's good, you know? So let me know in the comments below if you guys would be into that idea. I'd be glad to do it. Okay, last one. Just pure sugar and carbs and everything worth living for. Alrighty, that completes this video of the stuff I like. I actually like a lot more stuff than this, but if I listed it all, we would be here until tomorrow. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you want to see more like this, let me know in the comments below, or maybe just give this video a thumbs up. That'll be a good indicator that you want to see more like this. I like a lot of stuff, but the stuff I like is what I like all the time. I don't like new things often enough to post this type of video once a month, but I can film more in the future. And I'm definitely not gonna call it a favorites video because I just can't. It's too hard. Louie's my favorite. Chris is my favorite. I can't find enough favorite shit that is better than other shit I like. Does that make sense? Anyway, you know what I don't like is the collar on this shirt. This is the shirt that Chris got me from Disneyland. The neck on it is so freaking tight that I feel like I'm in a straitjacket all the time. I gotta like loosen it up every time I put it on. It just looks silly, and the arms are so huge that it kind of looks like, and God forbid you wear this without a bra on, the chafe is real. All right, I think that's a good place to end this video. That's enough out of me. Thank you guys very much for watching. Thank you for subscribing and staying subscribed, and I'll see you in my next one. Okay, love you, bye.